journey of all Christians is a path for progress. You must trust in the Lord to progress. It is a deliberate situation. The decision you must make. Let me tell you, growth does not just happen. You must arise, make a decision, and say enough is enough. You must make a decision. That's why I put in bracket trust. You must trust the Lord that is able to take you somewhere. Amen? Why must you trust? Because you are called to something. You are not a mistake. Keep remembering that. If you don't remember that, you'll give up and then you will not achieve anything in this world. That's what it is. Because you are called to something. This something means because God sees you as a finished product. It is you who's seeing yourself as a flop. But God in heaven is seeing you as a finished product. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I called you to become something. Have you ever seen a finished product? Yes. Something that is ready to be used. It is you, because you don't want to focus on what the Lord says. What are the promises? What is God saying about me? You keep focusing on what the world is saying. Some of you are even in church. You still remember what that show, who is a sorcerer, somewhere said, wewe nimekulani, ongoje uone, maisha yako, tuko na wewe hapa. If that is how you're still walking, that is what will direct you, that is what is going to shape you, and that's where you remain. Are you listening to me? Some of you, I know, you've already taken time. You went and cut ties, family ties. You pull them down. Don't continue cutting ties. What you need to arise now is to speak the promises of God upon your life. Those ties are not strong. You abolished all those things. It is over. All you need to believe that you prayed. The mistake is why you always go back to live in sin from where you are called from. When you know it's no longer about sin in your heart, then focus to what you are called to be. People struggle, go around because they disobey God. But if you walk away from disobedience, you have nothing to cry. Amen? No matter what is happening in your way. Because you are called to something. Because God sees you as what? A finished product. It is you who's still looking at yourself like an unfinished product. Me, I decided to start seeing what the Bible says about me. I am wonderfully made, fearfully made, carefully made. I am not a mistake. I am a finished product. I am going somewhere. I was called from somewhere, and I saw where I was called from. Are you listening to me? From idolatry, from stupidity, from foolishness, from sin. I was called from all those. And then I was called to something. Now I work very hard, focusing on the Lord to attend to that something that the Lord called me. But know this. Know that there is what? A space between now and where? And your future. That is why people do not concentrate to know. I am called to become something. But in that something, there is a ditch. There is a space between here to where God had called you. The way you live, the way you act, what you do, foolishness that God called you to walk away from. When you take care of that, you will win favor, you know, before God and a good name in the sight of God and men. And you'll succeed to do what God called you to do. Because God sees you as a finished product, you will finish and finish very well. Amen? There is a space. Up in Matthew chapter 16, 24 to 25.
Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me.
Now, if anyone would come after me, are you one of them? Church, are you one of them?
Yes. Mm-hmm. 25. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it.
Whoever wants to save his life will do what? Uh-huh.
But whoever loses his life for me
will
find it.
Now listen to me. Many times people have wrongly interpreted this scripture. Are you listening to me? It is not a difficult scripture the way you think it is. Many of you think it means leaving your job and coming serving God. That's not what the scripture is saying. Are you listening to me? That becomes an impossible equation. That's not what Jesus has said. I will show you what Jesus has said. What Jesus has said is this. Anyone who would like to come after me must take up his cross daily. Follow me. I will illustrate that first. Then I will be able to teach it and tell you what it means. Then today, take the report of the Lord. Run with it. Amen? Look at this. You are here. Are you listening to me? You are going where? This is Canaan. Are you listening to me? From this place to that place, there is what? A space. This space is called what? It's the abyss. This ditch, you must pass it. But to pass it, there are principles that you need to use for you to pass it. We concentrate on this man in yellow. Are you seeing him? Jesus says, anyone who would like to come after me must take up his cross daily and follow me. You can clearly see all of them took their cross and they started moving together. They started doing what? Moving together. But life isn't easy. Everything here on earth is complicated. Because why? Because it has the fallen nature. Are you listening? You do business with someone, and you are working with a certain boss, is not straightforward. And I find him again. Everything around life is just what? Complicated. You carry your cross as we are following all of us, Jesus. We are going. But don't forget, it will get tough because life is what? Complicated. Are you seeing? When the life is what? Complicated, this man from this place, he moved where? In front. Did you notice that? He used to be somewhere here. But he started moving a little bit faster than others. But the problem is always that we don't check what happened. Look at this man. He moved a little bit faster. Are you noticing this? But what people do not know, and we do not know many times in life, is that there are some people who start moving very fast because they took a shortcut. Are you listening to me? Suddenly in life, you're seeing them. They're having V8s, Land Cruisers. They are going, you know, they're looking like they have made it, isn't it? They have, you know, big churches. All this money is just flopping. You wonder, what are they doing that I'm not doing? Have you ever asked yourself that question? But there is something that happened. Though they are still coming in church, like they are carrying also their cross, following the Lord, but there was a shortcut. Are you listening to me? What happened is this. This is the man. You see, while he was walking alone, people did not know what basically happened. But what happened was that there was a time this man was not with us anymore. He went and put his cross down. Akaichinja. Umeelewa? Akaikata nusu because it was too heavy. Umesikia? Akakata cross yake. That's what he was doing. That's why he started walking alone and he took it to some extent. Akaichinja. Wakata ilichinja, mume notice, ikakua nusu. Nusu ashatoa. That is why this man, at this point, are you seeing him? Look at this cross. Look at the rest of the crosses. Ni munamona tuwako na pace, jamana elekea mali. Unaanza kujuliza, kwani ni nini endelea kwa maisha ujawa? Jamana tuwacha maze. Things are happening. The guy is taking what? A shortcut. He's taking a shortcut. His burden, his cross has no burden anymore. Nika kitu tu. Na jamana songa. Unachinda. Lakini sahi, you are under fasting. You are for retreats. I don't know what. You are in missions. You are doing this. Trying to do this. It's not working. But you are still crying to the Lord. Him is no longer that guy. It's this guy who walks in church 2 minutes. He comes to church even at 10 or at 11. You came at 8 making intercession. Yeah, mefika. Things became lighter for him. Oh, my shayake ata, nothing is working anymore. No more burdens. I don't want to carry burdens. When God gives him money, he says, this money is too much for Jesus. 1 million, I go and give to a church. For what? I'll give them 100,000. He gives you 100,000. Actually, even in church, the pastor says, wow, what a brother. Kumbi amewakula 900,000. Adam Jui, but he still comes to church. Shortcut is cross. Is a lighter one, a very lighter one, a very lighter one. That's the man. Kumbi, what you didn't know, how come he appeared to be ahead of every one of us? Because there was a place he stopped. He was alone. He thought that no one was seeing him, but God was seeing him. Aka chinja it, cross. Then ka cross kaka kwa? Mm-hmm. Akandelea hivi, kufanya hivi maisha yake, kila siku. Wakati Mungu anamwambia, let us go and pray. Let us do this. He always went somewhere. He said, this cross is what? Too heavy. He removes it. When everybody's in mission, people are doing the right way, the right thing, carrying the Lord's cross. He doesn't want. When he gets a fiancé, the Lord says, wait, live pure with that fiancé. He anasema, yoni maneno yenu. Shortcut. Ananyorosha. Things are working for him or for her. That is why this man is ahead. And everybody loves him. Everybody salute him with respect. But where with your cross every day, it is so heavy. Until you start feeling like, I can't take it anymore. It is too much. We have too many Christians that don't want to carry the burden of Jesus. That are just walking. They chop it every day. They don't want that serious Christianity. They compromise. And Satan has them in their camp while they're still in church, thinking that they're living for Jesus. No, it's a lie, like this man. But look at the pattern. They continued moving. All this man did not know that everyone is called out of something to something. Now he reaches, here is the ditch. Are you seeing that? Here is what? Everybody has to know from where you are called to where you're going. There is a starting place. There is a space between you and your future, which is what? Your promised land. Because God sees you as a finished product. The finished product is on the other side. Not this side. He reaches the place. He had to cross. He discovered it is only the cross that had to qualify you. The burden that you carried for Jesus, and he was not able anymore. Then he made an attempt. He found that his cross could not fit to make him cross on the other side. Every cross you carry is to take you to your promised land. If you don't carry it, you're not going anywhere. Look at this cross. Don't make shortcut with God. Respect him, trust the way. Walk with him wholeheartedly. When you make shortcut, you will never reach to your promised land. Usikule pesa ya Mungu. Umesikia? You will not cross. You will not go anywhere. If you try, you are in a ditch and it will be over for you. When you go in the ditch, at least before rapture has happened, cry unto him. Like who? Peter. Peter started sinking. Akusikia haya. I said, Jesus! Ninazama. Some of you munazama, you are not calling. Call upon the Lord. He will come for you. At least before rapture. Amen. To deny. Self does not mean to deny things. But to give yourself wholly to who? And do what? His shame is death. Are you listening to me? Like who? Israel for love. Are you listening to me? That is taking up your cross daily. He said, I cannot denounce my Jesus. I cannot deny my Jesus. If you have to take my 5 million contract, take it. I will not. But there are some brothers that are in the corporate there. They are in businesses. They are taking shortcuts, denouncing the ways of Christ so that they may succeed. You will succeed, but you will succeed miserably. There will be a curse in everything that you are doing. Never go shortcut with God. Give what belongs to God. I am talking to you because God is coming. If you are not believing it, you wait and see. When he brings new jobs, take it. What belongs to God? Even when you find the benefits was not enough to go and buy the other merchandise, you give what belongs to God first. As Romans, can you open all the scripture? You hear what Paul was saying.
Therefore, I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world.
Why are you conforming to the pattern of this world? Philippians chapter 3, verse 7 to 10.
But whatever was to my profit, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss compared to the surpassing greatness of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them rubbish that I may gain Christ.
Are you saying?
And
I consider all things lost. That's what I wanted to emphasize. People think that Paul was saying that I don't do. Was Paul a tent maker? Is that what he was saying? That I would throw it and not do anything? No. He was saying, they have no power over me. The things of the world have no power over me. They cannot take the place of God. Are you listening to me? God will always remain number one in everything. That's what Paul is saying. Galatians 2:20.
I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me.
Exactly.
The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Exactly. I live by faith. That's what you do. Amen? To take up a cross does not mean to carry burdens or have problems. Walk away from that. Are you listening? It's not that. To take up the cross means to identify with Christ in what? Is rejection. Every Christian will go through rejection. You identify with Christ. You identify with him in shame. In what? Suffering. And what? And death. That's what it means. Take up your cross daily and walk with me. The lesson is that suffering always leads to glory. If you don't like it, that's what it is. Like who? Like Joseph. All Christians must go through a pit from where you are to reach and become the finished product that the Lord is seeing. You must go through what? A pit. Including your own family will be against you. Are you listening to me? Including the people that claim that they love you, they'll stand against you. Never lie to yourself. Those are the things Christianity is telling you. Don't love your father more than Jesus Christ. Don't love your husband more than Jesus Christ. Don't love your children more than Jesus Christ. Jesus said, anyone who loves his father and his mother more than me, he is not worthy of me. Jesus must take the number one place. If you do that, you will rest in quiet waters. Like Joseph, every Christian must meet who? A Potiphar. Are you listening to me? Those will be accusations. Everyone must go through accusations. There is a space between you to your finished product. But you must trust the way. Are you listening to me? Many Christians are not trusting the way. That's why we're having a problem. You want shortcuts. You want a shortcut. Utafika. Here is the promised land, and you can't enter. You discover that you've been living for the things of the world for nothing. All this time, you deny Jesus. You didn't want to walk the way of honesty and integrity to do the things in the right way, the business in the right way. And that's what happened. Every Christian must meet a Potiphar. Are you listening to me? Accusations will come in your ways. A true Christian doesn't fight like that. I will show you how you fight. And every accusation, there are steps for your greatness. What will do? This will prepare you. Once a Christian, you lose the right to be. No Christian should fight in the flesh. Are you listening to me? They take things from you. You say, thank you. Go. Uskimbizane. Let me tell you. Uskimbizane watu. Acha now. Let them insult you. Let them do whatever they want to do. Keep quiet. Against such, there is no law. That's how you live as a Christian. You must go to prison as a Christian. So this is my conclusion. All you need, trust what? The process. Trust what? When it says any Christian, anyone who would like to come after me, must take up his cross daily. Follow me. Don't cut the cross to make it light. Are you listening to me? What you need to do? Trust the process. Go through it. Don't dodge. Don't go through loopholes. Don't go through excuses. Don't go to escape and jet out. There is a palace at the end of the process. And for you to enter in that palace, you must have a full cross. Do you see this man? He could not enter the palace. These ones, full crosses, they were able to enter their palaces. The Lord knows how to wipe our tears. Amen?
Nothing we want more but you.